Peck.
Oi!
Tiny!
Thank you. Here goes nothing.
And just like that, Evan had found himself the finest boat builders in all the land, and some timber worthy of their expert attention. Eager to get to work after their recent ordeal, the men of Capstan set about putting together a ship fit for a king. And before long, a magnificent vessel that no wave could hope to topple was all but ready to set sail.
Blimey.
Hey, up.
Yes!
Thank you.
Huh. Thank you. today. Thank you very much.
Gosh.
Here goes nothing.
Thank you.
Yes. All right.
I will never understand why the people love you so, Leander. Weak, insipid man. But love you they do. Without you, I would be nothing. That is what they whisper, is it not?
Without you, our nation would be nothing, Your Majesty. I above... But the people cannot know this. Foreign powers cannot know this. If they did...
If they did? Then what exactly?
Then your life would be in danger. Malign forces would plot your downfall. This is the way of power. So I put myself forward. If the people see me, deal with me, they can only become discontented with me, can only wish to harm me.
So all that you do for your queen. You would give your life for her without a moment's hesitation, yes?
Not without reason, Your Majesty. But if it might prolong your life for a single second, that would be reason enough. Such a death would bring honor upon me, upon my entire line.
Insipid you may be, but you are occasionally amusing.
You are too kind, Your Majesty. Yes. By all means.
Hey! Excuse me.
Oh.
What?
I have a wide range of items. Please come again.
Oh, hello. Yes. Welcome to Swift Solutions. Thank you. Oh, by the way, welcome to Swift Solutions. Oh, by the way,
today. Please come again. Oh, hello there.
Good day to you. Enjoy your stay.
Welcome.
Hello.
Do you require anything? Come again.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Excuse me.
Thanks.
What, Tarman?
Oi! Excuse me.
Wedding scene, take one, and action!
Look!
Is he
proposing? Tunny? Yes, Evan?
I care not a jot if
that's it.
Was that the rite of the ring?
Surely not. If must.
Oh,
focus, Tunny.
Well, Evan, you know what comes next.
What was that, man? Project?
Now pucker up, my boy.
Oh, no, you don't, lad. That's...
You there, you two.
But
there's no use denying it.
Well.
Excuse me?
Hmm. Hmm? Forgive me. Well. Yes.
Now,
if I may be so bold.
Yes.
Of course. Forgive me. All right.
Thank you.
lead.
They'll be singing me name over this!
Forward!
Finger! Finger!
There's plenty more where that came from!
Forgive me.
We can't afford to lose! Two,
eh?
George! more to lose!
Oh, careful, man!
From
Thank you.
Well,
you
Yes.
Yes.
But... what is it?
Yeah.
You have my thanks.
Thank you.
I may be so bold. Yes.
Here you be!
Flip, 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 flip!
Yes.
Shall we?
Come on! best!
Screw it! Take that!
Well.
Your Majesty! Your Majesty! Please!
It is too late for that, I'm afraid. Your queen is gone. Henceforth, she shall be my puppet. Nothing more.
You will return her to me now!
Tell me, why do you even care? Her people think little of her. She is powerless, weak, unloved.
Hydropolis would be nothing without its queen.
And why is that?
Even were I inclined to tell you, you would not understand.
So be it. Then I would ask that you do as your queen did and surrender your feeble spirit to me.
I surrender to none but Her Majesty.
Leander?
Is she coming around?
This has gone on long enough. Is doomed. But then beauty never lasts.
Brainskimmer, then the King's Bond truly is broken.
You heard the man, Ivan. No King's Bond, meaning we've got ourselves a kingmaker to clobber.
Come on!
Slip!
Take that!
Make yourselves useful.
Thank you. Hey. Of course.
Yes.
Yes.
Huh? Of course.
One day, Leander, one day we will marry, and you will be my king. We will rule together. Promise me.
I promise that I will marry you, that I will always protect you, that I will never leave your side.
Do you swear it on your life?
I do, Your Majesty.
Oh, Leander, I love you.
How could I forget? It is my most cherished memory, and the reason I gave my life to you in service.
But that was not what I asked. I asked that you become my husband, my king.
But the law of Hydropolis forbids it. I could not become king. I cannot.
Do not pretend, Leander. You know. You know better than any man of this realm. Whosoever possesses the ether possesses the right to rule. It was the first king of Hydropolis who brought it back with him, and with it claimed his crown.
But surely one such as I cannot...
Who better? Who else has guarded this realm more vigilantly? Cared for it more faithfully? As queen, I can accept no other. You must marry me. I command you.
But Your Majesty... I cannot.
Why? For the sake of the kingdom? The hallowed realm over which we have watched for so long? If we are joined in marriage, then all must end. Time cannot repeat itself. Hydropolis must fade.
Yes. And I cannot allow that to happen.
Let go, Leander. This realm may fade, but another will soon blossom in its place. New life, a new kingdom. It should have happened long ago. But I could not let it. I had to have one last day by your side. Again and again.
Your Majesty.
But it is time at last. I am ready, Leander. The wheel must turn again for Hydropolis. And if it brings our destruction, then so be it. It also brings truth.
Your mind is made up, then?
It is. So come, take your place by my side. Be my husband, my king.
I will.
The preparations for our union will begin at once, but you need not remain to oversee them. I hereby release you from your duties. You are free. These travelers have need of your aid. Go with them. Forget the concerns of our kingdom for a time.
Truly?
Truly.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let our nations be joined for the sake of the world.
Let the banners of war ne'er again be unfurled.
United we stand as one single land.
The pact is sealed. Our nations stand together. And now I must bid you farewell. Pray take care of my betrothed until his return.
We will. That is, assuming you're still happy to join us, Leander.
Of course. I only hope that I may be of use.
I'm sure you will.
Evan had freed Queen Nerea from Doloran's wicked clutches. And for his troubles, he had succeeded in adding another nation to his burgeoning union. With it came a great asset, Leander, whose wisdom would surely prove vital in Evermore's continued development.
A country where love is forbidden. How strange.
Yes, but I learned something there. I learned how fiercely a leader can long to protect their nation, and how much they can sacrifice for it. The Queen was prepared to devote her whole life to her kingdom, and for no one ever to know. I'm glad I met her. And Leander.
Well, there's still a way to go, and still an awful lot to learn.
Yes, I know.
In order to grow, we must first realize how small we are. It's going to be fun watching you grow into your older, wiser self.
Huh? What do you mean?
You're too busy building your kingdom to notice anything else, aren't you? All right. I'll see you soon, Evan.
Yes. See you soon.
My inventions will change the world.
I'll finish the perpetual fission reactor if it's the last thing I do.
Zip, please.
I don't care what it costs.
Chapter 6, The Price of Power.
Greetings.
I'll be counting on you.
Oi!
Blimey.
Forgive me. Of course.